Chase plays. If you see his Twitter handle, it's just top tiers only.
That's the right opinion.
And you know who he's yet to play who is a top tier?
Pyromithra?
Pit.
Anyways, I'm really curious to see who Jack is going to play. We got some hero action.
Hero versus Paolo. I really feel that Hero loses this matchup just because what Hero does really well is if he has space, he basically wins. He could either camp you out with his buffs, he could wait and use all of his other spells to try to get you, or he could just use his side B.
Right. Yeah, already 39%. Not too big of a Paolo combo coming in, but, you know, it's coming soon. There we are, the Nair pressure.
Hero's biggest weakness is his lack of frame data in the defensive option. Oh, I thought he was going to camouflage right there.
Yeah, we're going to be seeing those upbeats out of shield, which is like an option I didn't really think was real until you like kind of started seeing Hero do it a lot. I was like, wow, that's actually pretty good. And then you have like the upbeat mix-ups on ledge.
Yeah, upbeat mix-ups on ledge. He could also try to up tilt, up smash you if you're not mashing your jump.
And I think you're right about this matchup. Look at it. Hero's not getting that space to start throwing out his moves or anything. Just chases in his face. You don't got time to pull out the menu.
Exactly. But he has the accelerate now. Now he could create the space. But again, accelerate, he gets super, super light. Forward air.
I don't know if you saw that, but like as soon as the accelerate came in, Chase went back to like under the ledge because he knew he was going to drift over there and immediately punished it.
Really good awareness. Gets the bounce, but you know.
Yep, don't be reading up there.
Exactly. Once you're off stage and you pull out that menu trying to look for your zoom, unless you get that zoom, you're probably going to get hit with the back air.
On the ledge. Here we go. Here's the up airs. The pressure.
Reads the air dodge down. But yeah, Hero's going to do a lot of traditional moves to try to get out of disadvantage, such as spot dodge, such as air dodge, and especially just jumping out of shield. But the thing is, he doesn't have any moves to say, oh yeah, stop mashing buttons on me, right?
Uh-huh.
So this is kind of what we see when Chase is in the lead and just controlling all the space. Hero can't do anything.
Well, I do like that back air did hurt, but not gonna kill just yet. Here we go, gets the power up.
Psych up, he could kill right now. Actually, that would have killed if he got sucked into that kaboom.
There we go, that up tilt.
Yeah, psych up, up tilt, kills super, super early.
But this is still a deficit. Not to say Hero can't do it, but he's going to have to bring up the menu, and he doesn't even have the mana for that right now.
He has to get a hit. That's so much shield damage, but no more psych up.
Like you said, this is so scary. How do you get around those back airs? He was already in the air. He committed.
Exactly. He was in the air. When he tried to throw out his move, you just saw it clank with the back air. It's like, well, I guess I die here. But with accelerate, he can make the comeback.
True. Get some cheese. Yep. Chase going back into that defensive position. Saw that accelerate, but I don't have to hold that.
You saw the traditional spot dodge from Hero. That's really the only thing he could do out of disadvantage or when he knows that Chase is coming. But that gets stuffed out by Nair, that gets stuffed out by a down air if he reads it, you know.
I do like that. Wait for the shield to just go down naturally, then you're more likely to get that shield poke.
Fantastic run up under up tilt, and now he has the accelerate and the space to work with. I'm really hoping that he uses menu to try to find to try to find Psych Up, to try to get Chase to stay away from him even more.
Yeah, I do think at this point that is probably what the game plan might have to be, because just boxing Palutena right now is not working. Not going to die to that, I don't think. Yeah.
Super close. Zooms.
Tries to get the call out.
Fun fact, there's actually a high... Ooh, that's so cool. Chase
how,
is so
how
cool.
How did Jakku dodge all that? That was incredible.
I don't think Jakku even realized that he dodged it. He was kind of like, whoa.
You know, wow, man, I almost died. Yeah, Chase is looking like this is his game. Not much he has to do. He just has to not kaboom. Die right now, and he knows this game is his.
Yeah, I was going to say kaboom. Then.
Anyways, anyways shut up. Why are you cursing people like that?
Dude.
Check the controller. There might be some lag there. That was...
No, I like how the game sometimes just like, oh, yeah, we don't want to show anybody. We don't want to give them the right of day. It's just like, game. All right, go next game. Shake my hand.
Yeah, kind of caught him probably there on the DI. Follow that back. It can be really fast, so if you're not ready for it, you can get the no DI or sometimes even the bad DI. Got to it. I think that's what happened there.
Yep. And honestly, this looks super, super hard for Hero just because he can't create that space. The only thing that he can really do that I think he should start doing is dash dancing a lot more and trying to whiff punish the Nair, but that's easier said than done, right?
Mm. Yeah, like we said. Ooh. Oh, yo, bro.
Why?
I'm with it. I'd have lost my mind if that killed at zero. Isn't there like a 0.5% chance of that killing at zero or something?
Something insane like that, but at the same
time...
Yeah,
I remember seeing the chart like a year ago, but...
At the same time, there's like a bunch of stuff about here. Like, oh yeah, if you're off stage and in the glass zone, you have a higher percent chance of hitting Zoom and stuff like that, you know?
I also do like this this change of town again. Like you said, Hero wants that space, and what more space can you want than town and city? You have this long long stage and the platforms if you want. Plus the small side zones, it does seem like Hero is going to be coming off the side a lot more. That match was insane. He awoke before he hit the ground.
I was going to say, it's easier to mash in the air just because right when you hit the ground, you're able to do a lot of things. So when you hit a snooze in the air, I think, again, it's easier to get out of than when you're going to get hit.
Hold on, this is scary. Not getting that back air pretty cool, or that down air.
I thought he was going to thwack again, not going to lie.
I think in the back of his head he wanted to, but he's like, I got something to do. Back there.
Dude, look at that tomahawk grab on
like,
the
That's such a scary position to be, because if you DI away, what if you get hit? If you get hit at all, you're dead. But if you DI in, you're also going to be dead. So that's just a bad place to be in. Again, that power up tilt going to take that stock, but down two stocks to one. Here we go, bring out the menu. What are we ordering?
He's got all the buffs. He got bounce. He got oomph. He's got
Is he
going
to be able to hit him, though?
He is. See? 13%.
Did he just run underneath the auto reticle?
Nah, dude, he had the bounce, so he didn't really have to do anything.
True.
Fun fact, that actually would have killed Palu. Crit, psych up, up smash?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
50%? No, not gonna get that grab.
I was gonna say, that's like the one really huge issue, because if you expect to get hit by Hero.
There we go, that down air.
Yeah, if you really expect to get hit. And you spot dodge, it's kind of like, oh, you've given up your turn because you were too scared. And you kind of saw what happened when you're too scared. You get hit with that douche.
Like you said, that looked like a tough matchup.